I wonder how many people there are out there listening to this music. And it's late at night, maybe even after midnight. And no matter how you try, you just can't seem to be able to fall asleep. Your mind is just going mile a minute. Perhaps you're fixating in your mental processes of something that may have happened today or long ago. Maybe it's something you've eaten. Could be short-term or long-term problem. And then there are others who, as soon as their head hits the pillow, they're gone. That's a blessing, isn't it? Maybe it has nothing to do with conscience. Could be a chemical problem, or you are actually under stress or bondage. And there are those, then, who are depressed, who don't want to stay awake and who are afraid to sleep or dream. Hi, this is Night Sounds, and I welcome you. I'm Bill Pearce, and maybe we've met before. Having been on the air for over a quarter century, it would figure that we would be meeting many of you who have been there and around the block a couple of times and have sat through half hours with us for many, many years. And we are visiting new folk right now. Not sure how many. We're in automobiles, trucks, hospitals, private places of business, wherever you happen to be, late at night, with the radio on, to this station. Tonight's program finds me saying sentences like, "We speak to you out of the darkness," many times, because folk do turn off the lights and lie down, and some of them even get around a candle. I've read of that. But however we meet you tonight, in whatever kinds of light you happen to have, whatever your condition is emotionally, physically, spiritually, you are warmly welcome. We've called our time together tonight the darkness within, circling around the subject matter of depression. From her book, Still Waters, Jane Rubietta said, "Depression is a silent, insidious illness of the body and soul that manifests itself in the mind." This quote, excerpt from her journal, is a beginning of a journey, as she said, through the dark despair of depression and back into the light. She went on to mention this darkness can take many forms, from the blues, seasonal affective disorder, the postpartum depression, to the biochemically based, more serious bipolar and unipolar depression. And this broad spectrum can make depression very difficult to diagnose. But the estimated sufferers in the United States alone, just of the blues, are 10 to 20 million people. 25% of us will, at some time in our lives, experience a biochemical change in the brain that may be diagnosed as mental illness. The number of people who suffer from a serious depressive episode in any given year is roughly 10 million. And fewer than half of these will seek any medical treatment at all, preferring to suffer in silence rather than to risk the stigma of being diagnosed with a mental illness. Well, I often mention when we get into a subject like this that I am not an expert. I do not speak for anything except as we quote people and ask God to be very near us as we meet together, and perhaps a personal observation or impression. I am not a licensed counselor, nor am I a professional anything as far as the medical field is concerned, but I do take the opportunity to quote dependable and authoritative sources. I pray about the music, too, asking God to lead me to those selections that find their lyrics speaking to the subject at hand. Lisa Bethel is one of our contemporary singers, using the synthesizer to good advantage here to get us into a song that speaks of darkness and light. I'd like you to listen closely to the music of Night Sounds as we speak of the darkness within. Soloist Lisa Bethel, the song All Because of You. Song of survival, actually, and emergence once again into the light. Jesus said, I am the light of the world. He who follows me shall not walk in darkness, but shall have the light of life. Our program title tonight, The Darkness Within, speaking to the subject of depression. I'm quoting to some degree from Jane Rubietta's book, Still Waters. And evidently she has had a lot of personal experience with this illness. She did mention, too, that the World Health Organization predicts that depression will become the second largest global health problem within the next 25 years, following only heart problems in significance. This is partly because people underestimate the detrimental effects that depression can have on health. Depression robs its victims of joy, of simple pleasure, of laughter, of feelings, even of love. And it works havoc on our work and our relationships, draining families of vitality, depriving others of our gifts of attention, service, love. It pulls a dark cloud of depression around the being. Jane mentioned in her book, quote, I withdrew, wielding depression like a club to keep people away. Such isolation can contribute to the downward spiral. And we look at the costs of depression, which go far beyond the personal. Depression accounts for $43.7 billion per year, a burden on the American economy. Measured in medical costs, lost productivity, and depression-related suicide. Unfortunately, in both church and society, the widely held myths about depression keep so many in the dark. For instance, I would think that some would be embarrassed even to speak of it in a Christian context. In other words, Christians should not get depressed because, if for nothing else, the Bible speaks of the joy of the Lord being our strength. Mrs. Rubietta said, depression is neither a character flaw nor a sign of weak faith or unspirituality. Clinical depression, like cancer or diabetes, is a physical problem with mental symptoms externally caused. Depression results from agents outside of ourselves, such as grief, stress, pain. Many have been neutralized, or they may think healed, through chemicals, because it is a chemical disorder also. Mrs. Rubietta said, I would turn to a mentor of emotions management, the King of Israel, David. And his life pulsates with a full spectrum of feelings. He either leaps around praising God, calling down invectives on the enemy, or begs God to lift his head to restore the joy of his salvation. And the difference between David and many Christians is that he recognized and voiced his depression. And this king invited God into the process of restoration, confident that with the Lord's help, the depression could deepen his faith and bring him back into God's presence. And as we read through the scriptures, especially in the Old Testament, it seems there are other luminaries, major agents of God's blessing in his word, such as Elijah, who suffered from this. The prophet's enormous spiritual and physical workout with the false priests depleted him. You may recall this in 1 Kings 18. Depression often sweeps in after moments of significant spiritual accomplishment, as Elijah experienced after slaying the false prophets. We can blame the enemy, And Satan is certainly capable of taking advantage of us at this particular kind of a time. But research does show a correlation between stressful situations and resultant slumps of energy and adrenaline, all of which increase the likelihood of depression. I don't know if I can speak from any experience legitimately or not, but there were a couple of occasions where I can see a similarity, at least in the symptoms. One was when I had perhaps the most deep and basic and energetic moment of prayer for about a half hour, alone in a woods. I never had such an energized season of prayer in my life. I was totally immersed in it. The feeling I had when it was over was not one of elation, but of depression. It was scary, and I didn't understand it. Because prayer is not an escape necessarily, but prayer with our God finds us utilizing the greatest communication tool in the universe of all time. Jesus, at his greatest moment of desperation and despair, found himself in the Garden of Gethsemane, in agony, in prayer, such as none other ever experienced. So he certainly can be our mental picture, if nothing else. I don't think of him with that sweet, loving, halo-like look, with soft, wavy hair, or a halo, or anything like that. It reminds me of a painting that my father gave me before his death. I've always been absolutely entranced with that. I guess it's a painting. It's not a photograph, that's for sure. Of this figure in, not a garden, but the wilderness, a threatening environment. He was stretched down on a rock, his arms straight out before him, his head between his shoulders. He was gripping his hands in great stress. You could see the muscles, the sinews, the veins of his arms. His body was in a state of extension and of agony and of contention. He was contending, I believe, with the enemy of this world, the Prince of Darkness. So tonight, he is the one who is our centerpiece. He is the one who is the light of the world. He, Jesus, is that one figure of all time and eternity who can extract us from our darkness and lead us into his light. And I believe that God does use medical means and chemistry to help us. One of our Night Sounds personnel, a convert to Christ through this ministry, has been rejuvenated spiritually and later helped greatly through chemistry, medicine. So tonight, we're into a very deep subject, one that many of you suffer with. We hear from you. I think this is mentioned more than any other physical ailment. And we join in prayer every Thursday morning, and almost without question, there are two or three requests from those who are in various levels of depression. So tonight, I'm not here with any magic potions, but realizing that the power of God can help us through these awful moments. Elijah, David, find that depression often sweeps in to our souls at significant moments of spiritual exercise. Satan is certainly capable of taking advantage. But you know, he's a defeated enemy tonight. And we can just center on that for a moment. And thank God that he has said, greater is he who is in you than he who is in this world system. This is Night Sounds. I'm Bill Pearce with you, late at night, And as I mentioned a moment ago, speaking frequently out of the darkness. I'm glad you're there. Hope you can stay till the conclusion of the program. Our mailing address is Nightsounds, Wheaton, Illinois, 60189. Thank you for being there, for praying with and for us. And we do the same for you, especially as you voice your requests. Send them to us and we can pray more intelligently and directly about the concern. Into more music now. A song of freedom. A song of emergence.
A thousand times I fail, see your mercy remains. And should I stumble again, still I'm caught in your grace. Everlasting, your light will shine when all else fades. Never ending, your glory goes beyond all faith. Above all else, my purpose remains. The art of losing myself in breath.
And our subject, depression. And I see that we're well into our closing few moments here. So I bring in our theme once again. And it just seems to me that we should not discontinue this discussion, but perhaps carry it into the next program, and I'll make a little series out of it. There are so many gray areas involved in all of this, so many lines of demarcation and various levels. It's difficult for us to face it and to define it, but we can come to grips with our Lord spiritually to ask His comfort and direction in caring for those who are in deep states of depression. We pray for each other. Love always helps. So let's love each other regardless. Night Sounds, Wheaton, Illinois, 60189. Till we meet again, may God be with you and enlighten you and give you strength and a pleasant and peaceful good night to you.